Okay, here's the door latch assembly up closer. You have a wax motor with the black tip, and also you got this little fishing line in here. That goes over here by the dispenser, and what that's for is an emergency. If your door latch breaks, fails for whatever reason, you can turn the machine off and then pull that, and then you can actually remotely open the door up in emergency. Okay, here we have the wax motor. This is the new wax motor. It's got the black tip, but I'm just going to demonstrate on how to take this out. This spring clip is what pushes the wax motor over to the right. So we have to get the spring clip out first. And you gotta be careful with the sharp edges on it so you don't get cut. And also we'll remove the two wires. Needle nose will help with this operation. And once you get that out, just jiggle it out and wax motor come right out. Okay, putting the wax motor back in is a little bit trickier than getting it out. Okay, you have to, these flanges have to be up against this flat surface right here, all the way to the right. So once you get it in like that, you can tilt the wax motor out a little bit, and you gotta push this in just a little bit. You wanna slide the lock mechanism over to get that barb lined up, and then you push everything to the right. And if you get a problem where this comes apart, you can actually just pull in this little spring, and that will allow that to go back over. Okay? You want this to be resting up against this little stop right here, the flange on the wax motor. Okay, in this part of the wax motor installation, we want to take this clip. This little flat edge has to go back in this corner on the left side here. So what you do is you put the clip in, and you're going to need some needle nose. You got to be careful because the edges are kind of sharp on this clip. And you want to use a little screwdriver, just like that. That way this spring clip is actually pushing, you know, the wax motor over to the right. And the final step is we have to go ahead and hook the leads back up. Now these two leads, doesn't matter the polarity. You can have the white wires in the back, the brown wire up front. That's the way it was originally. It doesn't matter. It's an AC motor. It doesn't care. I've had some folks where they've actually pulled off all these wires and then they put a gray wire back on the wax motor and they had some problems. So you want to make sure if you remove any wires off these little micro switches that you mark them, and so you don't get them mixed up. So the two whites and then the brown should be going to the wax motor. And that's it.